The QRS complex represents ventricular depolarization and consists of three waves: Q, R, and S. However, not in every lead QRS complex contains all of these waves. Every wave can be described in the context of amplitude and duration. Let's start with Q wave. As you know, Q wave represents interventricular septum depolarization. Normally, Q can be present in all standard and augmented extremity leads. In addition, in the chest leads, Q wave can be present from V4 to V6. However, Q should be absent from V1 to V3. Amplitude of Q wave should be less than 25% of R amplitude in the same lead. For example, if the R amplitude is 10 mm high, 25% from 10 mm is 2.5 mm. Therefore, Q wave in this lead should be less than 2.5 mm in amplitude. Let's move to duration. The duration of Q wave should be less than 0.03 seconds. If the paper speed is 50 mm per second, 0.03 seconds is 1.5 small box. In other words, the Q wave should be less than 1.5 small box. If the duration of Q wave is more than 0.03 seconds, this Q wave called pathological. The pathological Q waves is very important signs of myocardial infarction. As an exclusion, is only AVR lead can contain big Q wave. It is occur because of opposite direction of AVR axis. So all ECG waves in AVR looks like inverted waves of second standard leads. According to this, Q wave can be deep and prominent in AVR. The R wave is depolarization of ventricular main mass. In standard leads, R wave amplitude depends on mean QRS axis. If the mean QRS axis is normal, the maximal R wave is located in second standard leads. And biphasic complex is in AVL. On the contrary, in the case of horizontal electrical position of the heart, the maximal R wave is located in first standard lead. And AVF standard lead represent biphasic complex. But in the case of vertical electrical position of the heart, the maximal R wave is located in third standard and biphasic complex can be found in first standard lead. In chest leads, R waves are characterized by normal R wave progression. It means amplitude of R waves should increase from minimal R in V1 to maximal R in V4. In V5 and V6, R should be smaller than in V4. Normally, in AVR, R-wave can be very small or even absent. Let's go to S-wave. The S-wave represents the polarization of ventricular basal parts. In amplitude, S-wave can be varied and even absent. Normally, S-wave should be less than 20 mm in amplitude in chest leads, and in extremity leads, S-wave should be less than 5 mm. Nevertheless, in AVR, S-wave is prominent. It is caused again by excess of AVR lead, and in this case, S-wave describes the main mass ventricular depolarization. In chest leads, S should gradually decrease in amplitude from V1 to V4 and has minimal amplitude in V5 and V6. Total duration of QRS complex is necessary for understanding of ventricular contractility. Normally, it should be less than 0.1 second.
Here we go!